don't need advancement. I'm already done. I'm already finished. I don't need any advancement. I'm already done. Just letting the cumulative effect of this, you know, settle in, letting the dust settle here. That's why giving it time is so important. Don't be in a rush. The less you're in a rush, the greater realizations will come that require quite a bit of time of settling down into it. I know I got this whole weekend. I can just, so whatever, bring it on. I don't need to do anything because I'm already finished. I don't need any circumstances because I'm already done. I don't need any situations because I'm already finished. So I don't need any situation to help me finish. I'm already done. I'm already finished. I don't need any circumstances to help me finish. I'm already finished. I know. I know that I'm already finished. The certainty will come upon us and we'll realize this is so. If it's already so, then it's so now. If I'm already enlightened, that means I'm already enlightened now. And since all we've been doing is trying to limit what doesn't exist, trying to learn to limit what doesn't exist, how does that affect what we are at all? It doesn't. See, there's not even any potential effect upon what we are. So we're already enlightened. That means, and since we're already enlightened, that means we're already enlightened right now. Doesn't exist already doesn't exist. It means it doesn't exist right now. Since it already doesn't exist right now, there's no causation at all. And say, I don't need to figure anything out. I've already figured it all out. I know I've already figured it all out. I know I'm already enlightened. I don't need to figure it out. want to be the guru? Do you want to be eventually want to be a guru? I don't need to be a guru, eventually be a guru. I already am. I know I already am the guru. I know that what doesn't exist already doesn't exist. We don't need to learn to limit its existence. It already doesn't exist. There's nothing we need to do, nothing we need to learn about nothing. There's nothing we need to learn about nothing. There is nothing we need to learn about nothing. Nothing is already nothing. Project success. Don't worry about it. We're getting used to this right now. I don't need to overcome any problems. I'm already finished. I know I've already finished. I know I already don't have any problems. Because nothing is already nothing. Still spirit exactly as God created me. And I know that nothing is already nothing. So I know I'm not a body. I know I'm already free. I know I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I know I've never been a body. I know I've always been free. I know I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So when you feel a little lag, just go back to this, you see. Start to feel a little bit getting off track. I just go right back to this. I know I'm not a body. I already know I'm not a body. I already know I'm free. I already know I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. I already know I'm not a body. I already know I'm free. I already know I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. So I'm adding a little twist to this thing. I already know. To the general form, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. We can say, I already know I'm not a body, I already know I'm free, I already know I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. I already know, I already am, I am, I already am, I already am, and nothing is already nothing. Non-existent is already non-existent. we're just trying to go as fast as possible. And we do so by saying, I don't need to go fast because I've already finished. I don't need to go fast because I know I've already finished. And we want to hurry up and finish, we do so by saying, I don't need to hurry up and finish because I know I've already finished. But we do need to practice this, you see. Absolutely, this is the bridge. I don't need to cross the bridge. I already crossed it. I don't need to cross the bridge. I've already crossed it. So we're evaporating the continuity fear very rapidly, and we can say, I don't need to rapidly evaporate the continuity fear. I know I've already done it. I know I've already finished. I know it's all gone. I know it's already all gone. And I know that nothing is already nothing. Need to awaken because I'm already awake. I know I'm already awake. And I know that nothing is already nothing. Let's not be in a hurry and say, okay, I got it. I don't need to get it. I know I'm already finished. I don't need to get it. I know I've already got it. I don't need to get it. I know I've already got it. I don't need to get anything. I know I've already got it. I know that when this, I tried to do this when I was young, the world said, you, how dare you be so insolent, so disrespectful and arrogant and, you know, like that. So this approach was crushed. And again, I say, I don't need any approach. I'm already here. This is, quote unquote, the right approach. The right approach is to affirm that you don't need any approach because you're already finished. What happened was that this world is so into time worshiping, they couldn't handle this information. Couldn't find any receptivity for it. And they said, well, it takes a lot of time to succeed. So I don't need any time to succeed. I've already succeeded. Well, that's not possible. You're just a child. I don't need to be a child. I'm already finished. I don't need time. I'm already timeless. I know I'm already timeless. And I know that nothing is already nothing. So now they say, well, you're, okay, now you put in all these years of work, and so now we can see how you might have been able to reach enlightenment. I don't need to reach enlightenment. I'm already enlightened. I know I'm already enlightened. So it's the same approach that I have always been an advocate of. It's just that the time worshiping here is so extreme that they wouldn't accept it coming from a child or for a young person. They said, you need time to learn. You need time to succeed. I said, I don't need to succeed. I've already succeeded. I don't need any success. I know I've already succeeded. I don't need any time to succeed. I know I'm already finished. But the time worshipping of this world is so severe. I can't accept it, can't accept it, can't accept it. So I don't need any time to think about it. I know I've already finished. And this is the practice. And I don't need any practice because I know I've already succeeded. Totally succeeded at the practice. I know I'm done. I know I'm already done. And yet, this is the practice, you see. Whatever it is we say, I don't need it, I'm already done. So ultimately, we're going towards realization. We don't have any needs at all. The spirit doesn't have any needs, which is, that's true. That's reality. It's already true that the spirit doesn't have any needs. Nothing is already nothing. So the practice is, I don't need to practice. I know I don't need to practice. I know I've already succeeded at practice. I've already totally succeeded. I don't need to think. I know I'm already done, I'm already finished, I've already succeeded. How to get anywhere. I don't need to figure out how to get anywhere. I'm already exactly where I am, where I want to be. I'm already where I want to be. I don't need to worship time. I'm already free of time. I don't need to worship time. I'm already free of time. I know. I already know I'm not a body. I already know I'm free. I already know I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. reason I like to keep the ball rolling is it's a lot easier to keep the ball rolling than it is to stop and then try to get it rolling again. That's what's difficult. So once you've got it going, don't stop. Keep going as long as possible. The will to get it going, that is the tough part. The will to drop time worshiping is the tough part, because when we easily get pulled into time worshiping in this world, and when we do, it's very difficult to shift into no time worshiping at all. So once you do make that shift, you know, get as much out of it as possible. I don't need to worship time on because I know I'm already free of time. And I know nothing is already nothing. To redo anything. I know I'm already done. I'm already finished. I don't need to redo it. I'm already done. I don't need to do it again. I'm already finished. I'm already done. I don't need to figure out a way. I know I've already finished. I don't need to figure out a way. I know I've already finished. So number one is the quiet sitting, still sitting, committed to not doing anything, not having to function in any way except just sitting here. And then secondly, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit exactly as God created me. This fallback affirmation we have. Relaxing our mind, we're releasing our thoughts, we're letting them go. We know we don't need them. We're stating, I don't need to be enlightened. We're stating, I'm already enlightened. I know I am already enlightened. I know I am already enlightened. And then stating, I don't need to get enlightened because I know I'm already enlightened. And then full stop in the wow. This is the package here, full stop in the wow. managing our success. I don't need to figure out what to do. I'm already finished. I know I'm already finished. I don't need to figure out what to do. I know I'm already finished. We say, what do I need to do? How do I keep the personality busy? I don't need to keep the personality busy. I know I'm already done. Well, if I don't keep the personality busy, it's gonna leave. Well, I don't need to keep the personality around. I know I've already finished. I'm already done. So we're just full stop in the wow. And the more we do this, the more we don't need the personality, the more the personality complex is detaching. We're detaching from it. I had the one instance where just before bed, it's sitting on the bed, and then I realized that the personality, the self, personality complex, was gone. I know where it was. It's gone AWOL. GTT, it's gone to Texas, maybe. I said, it's okay. Not a problem. I don't need to keep the personality complex busy because I'm already finished. I'm done. I know I'm done. I know I'm already here. I know that nothing is already nothing. So I don't need anything trying to learn to limit nothing. I know nothing is already nothing. I know I'm already experiencing bliss. I know I'm already experiencing enlightened light. I know I'm already experiencing a vision of oneness. I know I'm already experiencing the wide open light of seamless smoothness. If those guys can keep working, can't we keep working? You know what, we could be outworked here? Those guys are working on a Saturday, we can work on a Saturday too. Just let the dust settle, let the dust settle. This has been a massive upheaval here in our ideation, in our expectations. I know I'm already experiencing enlightened mind. See, I don't need a personality because I know I'm already experiencing enlightened mind. And I know that nothing is already nothing. I don't need freedom. I know I'm already free. I know I'm already free. I don't need anything. I know I already have everything. I don't need to get free of sickness. I know I'm already untouchably well. So we're just hanging out, getting used to this. This is the territory we're in now. Again, back to that beautiful resort hotel, and you just sitting there in a corner, just gradually you get familiar with the sights and the sounds and the ambience, right? You get used to the ambience of the place. You know, you can name things, although there's a desk, or there's a chair, or there's a table, but that's not the ambience. What we need to get used to is the ambience of the place. So I know I'm already experiencing enlightened ambience, the ambience of enlightenment. I know I'm already experiencing the ambience of enlightenment. So I don't need to improve anything. I know I'm already experiencing the ambience of enlightenment. I don't need to make any improvements. I know I'm already experiencing the ambience of enlightenment, of enlightened mind. I don't need to hurry up. I'm already here. I already have the ambience. I'm already experiencing the ambience of enlightened mind. I'm already experiencing the ambience of enlightened mind. I'm already experiencing the ambience of enlightened mind. So we're following the advice of Jesus here, who's given us very intense treatment for these quote-unquote times, which is really time worshiping that we're into this planet now. lot of intense time worshippers have found their way here and are beating the drums for time worship. So Jesus has given us this very intense treatment. So I'm just following, trusting, following along. I know I'm already experiencing the ambience of enlightened mind. And he says, as you believe this and believe it and state it and keep affirming and believing it, he says there will come a moment eventually where you'll realize it is true. And you will be experiencing it. And he says you already are, you just don't know it. So we keep practicing this. I know I'm already experiencing the ambience of enlightened mind. I know I'm already experiencing the ambience of enlightened mind. So then, see, this makes a nice segue. There's no continuity fear, because when we're experiencing it, I say, well, yeah, I know I'm already experiencing this. I know I'm already experiencing the dawn of the new day. I know I'm already experiencing the dawn that is the ambience of enlightened mind. I know I'm already experiencing this. And why do not we succeed immediately? Continuity fear. Time worshiping. It's like, not quite used to this. We can say, well, I'm already used to it because I'm already experiencing it. I don't need to get used to it because I'm already experiencing it. So I'm already experiencing it. So it may seem like we're tying everything in knots. Actually, we're untying all the knots. See, when you go through all the, like this, you know, the untying of knots is also seems quite a little bit confusing. Just as the tying up of confusion seems confusing, the untying of it all might seems a little like, I'm not quite sure what's going on. And then we realize, wow, I've already untied everything. I don't need to untie the knots. I've already untied all the knots. I don't need to remove the blockages. I've already removed all the blockages. They're all gone. Already all gone. All the blocks are already all gone. Need to remove any blocks because the blocks are already totally removed. I know the blocks are already totally gone, vanished, completely vanished. I don't need to make resistance vanish. I know it's already vanished. So this is a retraining of our mind, isn't it? Absolutely. A retraining of our mind. Jesus calls what his teaching, of course, really in mind training, but it really can, he said, a retraining. Of course, in mind retraining. And we would say, I don't need to train my mind at all. It's already drained. I know it's already drained. And yet this is the training, you see? I don't need to train my mind. I know it's already trained. I don't need to retrain my mind. I know it's already been retrained. And I know that nothing is already nothing. So no matter what the distractions of the world, it don't matter, does it? I don't need to succeed anyway, because I've already succeeded. So when we practice this way, the distractions don't matter. See, all these distractions did not affect me, my attention at all. Irrelevant. Because we're not trying to succeed here. We're just accepting the fact. I know I've already succeeded. So there's nothing that can interfere with my success. I don't need to protect my success. I know I've already succeeded. There's nothing can interfere with attainment because I've already attained. It's finished. It's already done. So if you find this a challenge, it's a challenge for me too. Absolutely, this mind retraining is, of course, it's a challenge. But it's the best way to spend time that I've ever spent. That is for sure. I've never spent a better block of time than this block of time. He who would lose his life shall gain it, right? I don't need a life because I know I've already got one. He who would try to gain his life will lose it. He who would let his life go shall gain it. So I don't need to gain a life. I don't need to gain any life because I know I already have life. I already am life. I don't need life. I already am life. I don't need life because I know I already am life. So we're continuing to full stop in the wow here. This is the discipline. This is the discipline. And if it seems like too much bother, well, just try facing the days ahead without the benefit of this discipline. And you'll realize it's not too much effort. And by no means is it too much effort. Future, because I have now. I already have now. See, I don't need any future because I already have now. Now, there's some who can talk very slickly about New Age, you know, quantum physics, quantum spirituality. Talk. Forget that. Forget that. I don't need to talk about anything. I've already succeeded. I know I'm already done. Practicing is what works. Not being some slick salesman on television about talk about New Age concepts. I don't need it to talk. I don't need any concepts. I know I'm already free of concepts. I don't need any concepts of how to be enlightened. I know I'm already enlightened. So it's those who are practicing this. This is what works. I know I don't need any understanding. I know I already understand. I know I already understand perfectly. This is another. Wow, just gotta hit real hard with this one. So you won't need tomorrow if you have today. You won't need the future if you have now. I don't need the future. I know I already have now. I don't need the future, I know I already have now. And see, now extends forever. So I don't need the future, I know I already have now. So again, we keep going. It's easier to keep going than it is to start another session. That is for sure. I don't need any success. I've already succeeded. See, we're still looking for success. Where's the success? I don't need to look for any success. I know I've already succeeded. Now this affliction that I've had, I can feel it evaporating. It is evaporating. Watching paint dry, don't pay any attention to it, but the spiritual heat is evaporating. This is like spiritual chemotherapy, actually, right? When you have a super malignant cancer, you can go in for, you know, chemotherapy and radiation, and you sit there in the chair getting these drugs put into you. It's not a pleasant sight. I've been taking tours through those places, and it's, God, yowks. Holy smokes. It's a very intense treatment, and it takes a while. It takes hours sometimes. They're just sitting there, just taking an hour. Well, we're doing spiritual chemotherapy, in a way, very intense. We sit here for hours, and it's just, just realizing we don't need the personality. Wow, we don't need the trial. We don't need this trying. We don't need this striving. We don't need this effort. We don't need this strategy. We don't need this uncertainty. We don't need this, well, I need to try again. We don't need this, all this determination. We don't need even the perseverance. We don't need anything because we're already free. I know I'm already free. I know that nothing is already nothing. So don't need it. Need the personality. This is, personality is the cancer. And this cancer is about ready to get very malignant in the world. The personality syndrome, which is really like a cancer, spiritual cancer, an imaginary one, but it can seem very real. This is going to become extremely malignant. It is becoming extremely malignant. And so we want to realize we don't have a personality. So there's no malignancy in us at all. I don't need a personality. I'm already done. I know I'm already done. I'm already home. I don't need a personality. I'm already home. So the last thing you want during these times, tribulation times, is a personality. You don't want a personality, that is for sure. Because it's going to become highly malignant. No question about it. I don't need to get free because I know I'm already free. Need to be helped because I know I'm already succeeded. I'm already finished. Person that comes along, well, here, I need to help you. I don't need to be helped. I'm already free. Well, see, we have outworked them. How about that? We have outworked our friends over there. You see, this is a very necessary spiritual chemotherapy. Goodbye to the personality. Very necessary. So, nobody's going to outwork us. Consists of saying, I don't need to work because I've already succeeded. I don't need to finish because I've already finished. I don't need any finishing effort because I've already finished. See? And for some, this will seem paradoxical. For those who get it, and realize I don't need to get it because I've already got it, then just a matter of doing it and managing your success. And we say, I don't need to do it because I've already done it. So this is the practice. And for those who can do it, who can say, I don't need to do it because I've already done it, and keep saying this, and keep saying it, and keep practicing it, this is evaporating the continuity fear. This is evaporating the ultimate fear, which is a fear that you don't have a personality. You don't have one who's trying to limit nothing. We think, we need something, aspect of what we are to limit nothing. I say, wait a minute, nothing, I already know that nothing is already nothing. I already know that nothing is already nothing. I already know that nothing is already nothing. already know that nothing is already nothing. So the more you practice this, the more you realize you don't need to practice because you've already succeeded. You don't need a practicer. I don't need a practicer because I've already finished. So you see, once we fully accept this, then there won't be any more practicer. There won't be any more neediness at all. There won't be anyone practicing to fulfill needs because I don't need any needs fulfilled. I'm already home. I already have the ambience of home. Now Jesus tells us, blessed are the poor in spirit. They shall inherit the kingdom, so to speak. If you are suffering, then you're going to realize, hey, I've got to, you know, I've got to get well here. I can't just wait around. I mean, I've got to really, you know, practice spiritual practice. I got to do it. So it's very helpful to have the thorn in the flesh, something that's really eating us up. So, wow, I'm getting eaten up here. Wow. Need to turn the tables, flip the script here. And so we'll actually work on flipping the script. So don't envy those who seem to be have these very prosperous personalities in the world right now. Don't envy them at all. That's the last thing you want. You don't want a personality at all. I don't need the future. I know I already have now. I don't need any of the future because I know I already have now. I don't need the future because I know I already have now. I already have the perfection of now, where I know that nothing is already nothing. So we go on faith to a large extent because the results don't show up immediately. Seem to be just delayed, slow in coming, delay, time worshiping delay. So we go on faith here. And it's not always easy, but you know, what can we do? We got to. I know all the fabled results, you know, have not yet shown up. That's just the way it is. That just means that there is some delay still present, that's all. Just have to keep working at it. I know I don't need the future at all. I know I don't need the future because I know I already have now. I know I don't need the future because I know I already have now. You know, without the rain, there's a lack of insects, lack of water, lack of insects. Without the insects, there's a lack of birds. I mean, it's a complete conflagration. There's no water in the creeks, there's no frogs, there's no tadpoles, there's no frogs, there's no chorus of frogs at night. Without the greenery, there's not enough crickets and birds. It goes all the way down. It reverberates throughout the entire ecosystem. Without water, there's no life, so to speak, in California. Wow. They'd say that the pigeons are dying because there's no water. They're coming to bird feeders and they're getting some kind of virus out of the bird feeders, that stagnant water or something in bird baths or whatever. They've got the virus again that's causing a broadband pigeon die off. Broadband-tailed pigeon die off. So there's all this stuff going on. See, this is personality, but we don't need the personality because we're already free. We know that nothing is already nothing. We don't need the future, any of the future, because I know, I already have now. I don't need the future because I know I already have now. I don't need now to impact the future because I already have now. I know I already have now. So I know I don't have to impact the future in any way. I know I don't have to impact the future in any way because I already have now. So I know I don't need to impact the future in any way, because I know I already have now. I'm already now. I'm already now. I know I'm already now. I don't need to impact the future in any way, because I know I'm already now. Wow. I'm gonna have to full stop in this one, because this is just again, and just another stunner. But this is great. This is what we're here for. Yeah, now. I already have now. I know I already am now. I know I already am. I am now. And I know, I already know that nothing is already nothing. So I know, and I know I already am now. I know I am already now. This has been like just an overwhelming session here, which is what we need. We need that intensity. Keep full stop in the now. It's not easy. This one really hit so hard. But just have to keep do my best. Don't project in the future. Take yourself out of right. You know what? Right now. No. To stay right now with the shock. Escape the shock by using believing in time, future. That makes things worse. It nullifies it. So when something hits you really hard, that's good. Don't apologize for it. You may be quiet for a while. What we're doing in retraining our mind is supposed to hit us hard. It's supposed to have startling, amazing success. Which means you will go quiet. You'll go quiet. Be quiet for a while. You know, the constantly bubbly evanescentness is often a defense. willingness to be quiet is very important, because that the shock of the success stuns you into silence, really. It's like so consequential, you can't even talk about it. You just realize, you know, hey, the game is up. This is so consequential, I can't even say anything about it, really. It's best to say nothing. That gives a better impression of the consequentiality of it. I'm already now. I am already entirely now. So by saying this, we're getting close to experiencing it. Which is, of course, the antidote. That we have the ace up our sleeve, absolutely. Time to play that ace up our sleeve. We need to kind of shake the sleeve, you know, to get that ace out of our sleeve. We've been hiding this ace up our sleeve and waiting for the time when we really need to play it. Well, we really need to play it now, I tell you. Because the personality can become extraordinarily agitated, take it from me, because I've already experienced this. In fact, the personality can become so problematic, you can't believe how problematic it can become. So we want to disinvest in the personality. We want to dump our stock in the personality as fast as possible here. This is an total stock dump we're engaged in here. You know, we've got the trading machine just humming, and we are absolutely liquidating all our stock in the personality, totally. Divesting ourselves of the personality. I already know I'm not a body. I already know I'm free. I already know I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. Dump your stock in the personality before the world dumps its stock and shocks the personality into slavitude, you know, really. Personality can become so demoralized and shocked and stunned that it just feels like it being enslaved, you can't do anything about it, really, yeah. Dump all the stock in the personality, liquidate it immediately. And we can say by practicing, we can say, I don't need to liquidate all my stock in the personality because I've already done it. It's already been accomplished. I've already done it. And actually by saying that, you have already done it. So it's amazing, isn't it? By saying that I've already done it, that is the doing of it. That is the already doing of it. And we just have to gain acceptance of our power You see, we try to disempower ourselves, so we have a difficult time accepting how powerful we actually are. And we're so powerful that just by saying that I've already done it, it is already done. There are no barriers of time, space, process, and forms of spirit, none whatsoever. So when I say I've already liquidated all my stock in the personality, it's already done, then that means it is already done. Be said, so shall it be done. Yeah. But we don't need any slaves to do it for us. It's already done. See, there's no idea of slavery in reality because everything is already done. Whatever is done is already done. As I desire it, it's already done. It's concurrent. And from the standpoint of concepts, the only way we can say is it's already done. Because absolute spontaneous, concurrent immediacy is something that is cannot be expressed in concepts, really. So the only way we can say it is that it's already done. It's already done. So we're engaged in an all-out stock dump here before. They freeze trading on this, you know. the stock situation in the world. People feel that they suddenly lost their ability to impact the future in the way they want to. The personalities will just go bonkers. Well, how do I do it? I don't know how do I do it. Building up. Until you just this colossal mind just thoughts, fast humming of concern and thinking. I've been there, done that, know exactly what that's like. Dump all stock in the personality right now. You do not want that. Don't need it. Because you're already free. You're already now. I am already now. I don't need to impact the future because I'm already now. I know I am already now. Stock in the personality. And we do that by saying, I don't need to dump the stock in the personality because I've already done it. I've already done it. See, we keep the personality thinking, well, we need to impact the future in a positive way so that we can learn to limit loss and learn to limit time loss, you know, learn to limit nothing. And so we have expectations of how can we impact the future, etc. Well, when all of that crumbles, then what happens to all our expectations and our functioning and everything? Personality, goes crazy. Yeah, but you have a crazy personality. It goes bonkers. But we, having already divested ourselves of the personality, we don't need to. I don't even need to divest the personality because I've already done it. This is, practice this. I don't need to get free of the personality because I've already done it. It's already done. Done deal. This is the most radical way, the best way to do it, is to say I've already done it. Because you don't want to use the personality to get free of the personality. Absolutely not. Because it's totally involved in using time and limiting, trying to limit. I don't need to limit anything because I know that nothing is already nothing. I don't need to learn to limit nothing. So we have to say, I'm already free of the person. I don't have to get free of the personality because I'm already free. I already got free. I already got free of the personality. So we speak in warnings and urgencies in one way, and then our practicing, we flip the script, okay? So I'm saying, yeah, we definitely have to divest of the personality. But to do it, we flip the script and say we've already done it. Okay, so this should be, you should be getting used to this more and more and more. Sure, we can talk about the urgency of the times, the severe problems the personality is going to have. Why? So that people can be enslaved, actually. People can be easily eliminated, enslaved, gotten rid of. Lots, you know, it becomes putty in the hands of those who are orchestrating this. And again, having been there, doesn't matter how proud you are, how intelligent you are, etc. You just feel like you're helpless. Your personality is just doesn't know what to do. You just feel hopeless and helpless, and it's terrible. So this is the urgency. Don't bank on having a powerful personality, a successful personality. That is the worst thing possible. We're not trying to empower any personality here. We're realizing, I don't need to empower any personality. I'm already free of the personality. I know I've already dumped the personality entirely. That's already been done. This is a shocking wow. See, when you get up to the point where you really believe it, that's when you feel the impact. So we're not just mouthing these things as words. We believe in this. We really believe this. This is absolutely true. We really know that nothing, we already know that nothing is already nothing. And so there isn't any need to limit nothing, right? So we don't need a limiting mechanism called the personality. And since we already don't need it, we can say, I've already dumped it. Because I know I don't need it. So I say, I know I've already dumped it. Once I realize I don't need this, that is the dumping of it. That's how powerful we are. We're spirit. We're not bound by time, space, process, and form, by these illusions at all. No. So, I'm not watching the news. Hardly at all. I know there's this Dawn space probe that's going to come into the embrace of the gravitational field of Ceres, this dwarf planet Ceres, on about 5 or 6 days. The measurements, and then it'll progressively get closer, taking pictures and getting closer and taking measurements over the next year or so. Until it finally loses all its fuel and just be abandoned into a stable orbit around Ceres. And that's about it. As far as news goes, that's about all I'm aware of. This is somewhat interesting. But not enough to capture the attention here. We have to keep practicing. There'll probably be a lot of buzz about this. You know, this water planet could have an ocean underneath. Well, Europa already has an ocean. There's already some planets, moons of Jupiter that have oceans. There's a lot of water we're discovering a lot of water. This is pretty interesting because, yeah, I mean, there are ways that the hot core of this dwarf planet providing thermal energy, you know, for the ocean, and there's a lot of you know, intriguing possibilities from the standpoint of the personality. But you see, the thing is, I don't have a personality. Because I know I've already gotten rid of it. I don't have a future because I know I've already gotten rid of it. I know I already have now. I already am now. So we need to limit. Be careful. Don't get pulled into these stories. Keep practicing here. This divesting your stock in the personality is the house on fire, hair on fire, immediate, super important objective. To practice this as if I've already done it. That's how important it is. Okay, so let's see if I've kept this under 2 hours. I don't know. Maybe not. That's okay. We'll maybe put a part two up or something. We'll see. But okay, so this is a nice 2-hour block of extreme effort to divest all stock in the personality. Extreme efforts, because there will be extreme turmoil brought to the personality very soon. So let us keep these extreme efforts going. Okay, very great. That's it.